That shit wasn't scary at all, man. Like, I was not scared. Neither none of those are scary.
Seem like my life been really changing on me. I know some niggas out here hating on me. Hey, I see the bitches how they changing on me. I know some niggas out here snaking on me. Hey,
see like my. Alright, so here's the deal. I was told that I need to do some goddamn. Hold on, let me put this camera down a little bit. Just a little tiny, little bit. Alright, so look, I was told I need. Oh, shit, fucking up. Alright, so look, I was told that I needed to do some scary action. And they say I gotta do it in the dark. But you know what's crazy? I'm dark, nigga. How the fuck y'all gonna see me in the dark? You know what I'm saying? But shit.
You like money?
Hell yeah, nigga. What kind of question is that?
Man, I know somebody that's giving away 5 gift cards.
5?
5 after 5,000 subscribers.
How many subscribers they need?
Shit, like 1,000 left.
Oh, ain't bad. We can help them out, bro. Let's go do 1,000 accounts, nigga. I'm trying to get them 5 goddamn gift cards.
Then they're doing t-shirts, too.
Oh, how many?
5.
Oh, nigga, that's a whole week. Nigga, be fresh for a whole week. What you putting on a t-shirt? What the, you can put anything?
Yeah, you can put whatever you want.
Oh, pictures, too?
Pictures, too. Pictures and all.
Black and white?
Black and white.
Color? Oh,
nah, color, yeah.
Color, too? Oh, nigga, I gotta do that, bro. How you doing?
You can pick your shirt, too.
All you gotta do is subscribe and comment, right?
Subscribe and comment, yeah. Subscribe and comment.
Subscribe, comment.
Hit the notification bell.
Please, and share.
And like it.
You gotta like. The more likes you get, the more YouTube gonna show us. If y'all wanna win these gift cards, y'all wanna win these t-shirts, you gotta run it up.
It's a real gift card. Real money. Not handing you cash, though.
Nah, I can't do cash. Gift cards only.
Gift cards.
Gift cards only.
We got gift cards.
We got them.
And then at 10,000 subscribers.
Oh, I forgot about that. They giving away an iPhone 12. iPhone whatever color 12. You want, whatever service you with.
Finna get mine right now.
Real talk.
Just to make sure y'all shit work.
Real talk. So y'all make sure y'all run it up.
Let's go ahead and get to it, man. Twigga gonna do some new reactions, new type of shit. Top 10 times ghosts were actually caught on camera. Do I believe in ghosts? Not really. But I guess we gonna fucking see if I get scared or not. Let me turn this off right quick. But look, let's get into it, man. Top 10 times ghosts were actually caught on camera. Let's see, record, play.
At first I thought it was a camera problem. Again.
Welcome to Watch Mojo.
I'm about to say.
And today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 creepiest ghosts caught on camera.
Let's see them then.
See the face of a famous ghost caught on camera? Turn it off!
I can't see that. I was never scared of it or none of that shit.
She came back to pick up her print, and lo and behold, there was Abraham Lincoln standing behind her.
Oh, wow.
He's got his hands on her shoulders.
For this list, we'll be looking at mysterious figures
believed
to be ghosts. Whether you believe these are the real deal or not, this imagery will give you the chills.
That's definitely
not
real.
Do you believe in ghosts?
No,
let us know in the comments.
I don't believe in nothing.
Number 10,
I believe in something.
The works of William Hope.
What are we?
William Hope was one of the first individuals to specialize in spirit photography, putting together a portfolio of otherworldly
images. Let's see how good he is.
He even served as the founder and leader of the Crew Circle Spiritualist Group. Some of Hope's spirit photos were proven to be fake, and many believed that he was a fraud in general.
See?
Even so, Hope
how
would give us some
anything?
Of the most iconic photos in all of ghost hunting. In a photo of Charles Tweedale,
you can tell that's fake.
The spirit of her late father can allegedly be seen in the background. A similar photo supposedly reunited Mr. and Mrs. Gibson with their late son. Arguably the most famous
I don't
photo
believe that. That Mrs. shit don't look like it's real.
Robertson, as her departed husband loomed over her. Number 9. Terrifying terror.
10 wasn't scary.
Losing a cherished pet is never easy, although it wasn't
pet
the
ghost
who had to bid farewell to this terrier. The bigger dog in this other photo, which was taken a few weeks after the loss, was the terrier's playmate. The terrier's death took a noticeable toll on the big dog, but the pooch's little friend might have been closer than anyone thought.
Oh, I see it.
If you look closer
on his ass.
In the photo, you can spot what looks like the terrier levitating over the big dog.
He got a dog stuck in his ass.
Looking dog, or was the terrier not ready to go to the big fire hydrant?
It's in his ass.
In any case, the story was fascinating enough to make it into a 1930s.
I got German Shepherd.
Life magazine. Number 8.
I got German Shepherd.
King.
Nah, one's scary.
The last man, Chicago.
Yes, at least a dozen people send their love.
At least a dozen people share their love or send their love.
Absolutely in mourning.
What it goes
no amount of fire or freshness can challenge what a man will store up in his ghostly heart.
Where
that's
at?
One of Daisy Buchanan's most memorable
Daisy?
In F. Scott Fitzgerald's
Your parents named you
Oprah,
Daisy?
The Great Gatsby. It's widely believed
it's
that Daisy
up.
Was inspired by socialite Genevra King, who was briefly involved with Fitzgerald during their youth. King passed away in 1980, but could the green light still be burning at the end of the dock?
No.
This photo taken by Christy Ranieri.
That might be real.
Seems to suggest so.
No.
Ranieri
that ain't
was outside
real.
King's old farm home in Lake Forest,
this
Illinois.
Chin
when she captured this
is above
image.
The
Ranieri believes that the strange
above
face
the lines
ghost.
For where the wood is, the hose the window. Chin's on the outside. Almost got me.
You're there all along. The
almost got me.
Every decision.
That's a good actor, though.
Of course,
Leonardo DiCaprio, good ass actor.
Yay.
That's gay. I can't be doing ads while I'm doing this shit.
That is as easy as.
Alright, so look, I'm finna skip the ads, but y'all don't skip my ads, though.
Number 7, the Brown Lady of Rainy Hall.
Nope.
The only thing more chilling than this photo is its backstory. The ghostly figure is supposedly
Lady
Dorothy Walpole, the sister of Prime Minister Robert Walpole, and the second wife of Charles
Townsend. She
could've
got it back in the day.
As legend has it, Townsend learned that Dorothy had an affair with nobleman Thomas Wharton prior to their marriage. Holding a fake funeral for her, Townsend locked Dorothy up at Raynham Hall, where she remained until her passing in 1726.
Yeah, he locked up and left her there for that long.
Rumors, this photography is all the proof some spiritualists need. Taken by Captain Hubert C. Provand in 1936, the photo supposedly shows Dorothy's ghost wandering down the stairs of Raynham Hall. She was apparently wearing a brown dress.
I didn't know she running.
It's the nickname
Come on
the Brown
now.
Lady. Number 6.
They call
Spectre
me the Brown Man.
Navy Church. In 1963, Reverend Kenneth F. Lord snapped
That's so
photo
fake.
Inside the Newby Hall Church of Christ the Consoler. The church's beautiful architecture is largely outshined by a dark figure hanging out in the corner. Wearing what appears to be a hooded robe and a white shroud, the ghostly figure came to be known as the Newby Monk, as well as
the
Spectre of Newby Church. Where some people believe this to be a 9-foot-tall 16th century monk, others claim that it's merely a costumed accomplice standing on a box.
That's all it is.
It's also been theorized that the figure is a product of double exposure, which is when multiple images are placed over each other to create a single image.
Yep.
Although a few photography experts would beg to differ.
Oh, whatever.
Number 5, Ellen Hamill. The stranger in the back seat.
Who that nigga in the back seat?
And this spine-chilling photo only gives more reason to keep an eye on.
Who that nigga in the back seat?
In 1959, Mabel Chinnery.
Just like the nigga on what's that movie? How high?
Car.
When he smoked him, he was in the back seat.
Ellen Hamill can supposedly be seen in the back seat. The thing is, Mrs. Hamill had died a week earlier, and the photo was taken shortly after visiting
Annabelle's
her
grave. Scary.
What's more, Chinnery's mother liked to sit in the exact spot whenever Mr. Chinnery drove her around. Again, double exposure might
scary.
Be the obvious explanation
Put
for the
something strange
However,
in a neighborhood.
One photo expert believed it was genuine, according to Parade magazine,
the lady
which
in the
published
back seat.
The story. Number 4, Freddie Jackson.
I'm scared.
At first glance, this photo of a Royal Air Force squad.
I'm a positive. First glance, let me see if I can find it. Let me see if I can find the ghost real quick. Hold up, wait a minute, where the fuck is the ghost sitting? I don't see a ghost, I don't see a ghost.
It might not seem like anything out of the ordinary.
Not yet.
It stands out for two reasons though.
Why?
First, it was taken by Sir Victor Goddard, who fought in both world wars.
Appreciate
Second,
you.
You can allegedly see the ghost of air mechanic Freddie Jackson in the background.
Where?
2 days before the photo was taken
Show
in 1919,
it.
Jackson tragically died in an airplane propeller accident.
Damn,
those
sucks.
Who knew Freddie couldn't help but notice his resemblance to the ghost.
Oh, that nigga do got somebody behind him!
I like to think that Jackson was unaware of his passing and thus joined in the group pic. The photo was later published in 1975, and the exact nature behind it continues.
That one was a little chilly, I ain't gonna lie.
Number 3, Lord Cumbermere.
Cumbermere!
In 1981, the second Viscount Cumbermere was laid to rest. If this photo is any indication,
you see him in a chair?
Lord Cumbermere might have been absent from his own funeral.
I see him in a chair.
Shortly before the funeral, Lord Cumbermere's sister-in-law, Sybil Corbet, arranged a
Sybil
camera
Corbet.
At the Abbey Library and took an hour-long exposure. Cumbermere Abbey was 4 miles away from St. Margaret's Church where
picture.
The funeral was being held. When the photo was developed, an apparition resembling Lord
Not
Cumbermere
scary.
Was found sitting in his favorite chair. The most logical explanation is that one of the staff members stayed behind and sat in the chair, although they were all apparently at the funeral. Perhaps Lord Cumbermere was taking a brief rest before moving on to the great beyond.
I don't know, guys. I'm not seeing it.
Hey, it's time to sell the house.
Sorry, Mojo.
That is as easy
I gotta
as...
skip your ads. Well, but I'm not seeing it, though.
Number 2, the Amityville Ghost. Ronald DeFeo Jr. was infamously responsible for the deaths of six family members in 1974.
You a hoe, bro.
13 months after the murders took place,
the DeFeo house
was purchased by the Lutz family, who left after 28 days due to alleged paranormal activity.
I bet that's just scary. Oh, that's how they made a movie off of it. Okay. The Amityville Horror, I seen that. Ghost when you get that ass, nigga.
This would all provide the basis for the Amityville Horror books and films.
And the movies.
But is the house truly haunted?
I doubt
it. Who better to find out than Ed and Lorraine?
I married at the Conjuring. That was a good ass movie. Me and my baby mama love that movie.
Investigating the house.
Departed.
The Warrens walked away with a photo of a
boy. What you doing back there, ghosty?
There were apparently no children in the house, leading some to believe that this was the ghost of 9-year-old John Matthew DeFeo, Ronald's brother.
That's my name, John.
Before we unveil our most ghostly number one pick, here are a few honorable mentions. The original
photo
bomb.
The fuck is that? The fuck is that?
Ghost on the Tulip Staircase.
Oh man, come on, y'all gotta do better than that, bro.
Come play with us at the Stanley Hotel.
And I'm a little smurge.
Jason Griffith's grandfather, 2 months after he passed.
I don't know about that one.
Man in Black at Sefton Church.
Oh, I see him. He chilling, posted up. Okay. Okay.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos.
All right, Mojo.
You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications.
Thank you. Let's get to number one.
Abraham Lincoln.
AB!
There was William Hope.
That's what they're talking about it, like when I have my chin shit done.
Widely considered the first spirit photographer.
Like a
Although many
like
believed
ape.
Mumler to be a fraud, this photo would forever engrave his name in the paranormal history.
Oh, shit!
She came back to pick up her print, and lo and behold, there was Abraham Lincoln standing behind her. He's got his hands on her shoulders.
Mumler's subject is Mary Todd Lincoln.
I don't know about that one either, bro.
His hand on her shoulders is allegedly President Abraham Lincoln, who was, of course, assassinated in 1865. It's been said that this photo was taken in 1869,
and Mumler didn't know
until after it developed that Mrs. Lincoln had been in his presence. Another account claims that Mumler took it in the 1870s, and Mrs. Lincoln approached him under a pseudonym. As for the photo's legitimacy, maybe it's fake.
I want a skirt.
Only honest Abe himself would know for sure.
Tell me, Abe.
Do you agree with our pick?
All right, so that was all right, I guess, you know. So that shit wasn't scary at all, man. Like, I was not scared. None of those are scary. I gotta actually watch some shit that's moving and not no picture shit, because that shit was not scary, man. So look. Maybe y'all like it, maybe y'all won't. Like, comment, subscribe, do what y'all do. Shout out to Papa Duck, you know what I'm talking about? That's where I got my shit from. If y'all know who Papa Duck is, watch him on YouTube. But that shit was not scary, man. Took him want to get scared, man. Over and out.